Hi, I'm Jason Gong. I'm a first year PhD student in the Department of Communication at UC Davis. Here I'm introducing one of the projects in our lab. This project investigates the state of flow, and we are applying a brain functional dynamic network analysis on the flow fMRI data. So the first question to ask is, what is flow? The flow is introduced by Csikszentmihalyi, and it's a phenomenon to describe when people are playing chess with friends solving puzzles, or when they are playing video games, they will feel the disappearance of self-consciousness, the loss of temporal awareness, and they will have the pleasant and intrinsic motivation to do the task. Also, their attention on the task will increase. The second question to ask is, how is flow induced? The flow theory basically suggests that the flow is induced by the balance between difficulty and ability. If there is no balance, like difficulty is high, then people would like to enter the state of anxiety. If the people's ability is high, then people are going to enter the state of boredom as predicted by the theory. So our research question here is to ask, what is the neurodynamics of the flow? There are some previous fMRI data suggest that there is some neural correlation with the state of flow, such as the activation in cognitive control and reward networks, and the downregulation in default mode network. Also, the synchronization theory of flow suggests that the flow is an energetic, optimized, discrete brain state that is induced by synchronization of attention and reward networks. But these findings does not tell us too much about the brain dynamics, so we are still unsure about how the brain evolves as either a network or as a complex system. So here, our main goal is to answer this question. We have two goals. The first goal is just to validate this naturalistic experimental behavior induction. Our second goal in this experiment is we want to explore the brain dynamics during flow. We use two approaches. The first approach is a multi-layer community detection on the dynamic functional brain network, and we calculate node flexibility. The second approach is to calculate synchrony and metastability of the flow based on a brain coordination dynamics model. So the experimental paradigm is called asteroid impact. In this task, people are controlling a spaceship, and they need to collect crystals as much as possible. They also need to avoid the asteroid. The asteroid is moving, and the difficulty of the task is manipulated by the speed of the asteroid. If the speed is high, then the difficulty is high, and the state of flow is induced by the algorithms that is monitoring people's performance and matches the difficulty with their performance. So there is a balance between the difficulty and the ability, then supposedly they would enter the state of flow. Also, there is another behavioral measure which is called a secondary task. And so there is a red dot flash on the screen, and when the signal appears, the participant need to respond to the button as quickly as possible. And the response time is used to measure the attention on the main task. If the response is high, then they have high attention on the main task. If the response is low, then that shows they have low attention on the main task. So our behavioral results basically replicate the previous findings, that the self-reported flow, self-reported enjoyment, and also the secondary task reaction time measure, the attention measure, has this U-shape as a function of difficulty. Our fMRI analysis basically, it extract the functional, the dynamic functional network use time window. So we have four time windows, and the threshold and binarize the correlation matrix of the time series, and we apply a community detection of the nodes, and use the community membership. We calculate the flexibility. So the flexibility is basically capturing how much the nodes changes its community membership across time. So second, our second approach is in friction domain. We calculate metastability of the oscillation nodes in the system and the synchrony of the nodes in the system by applying a Hilbert transformation, and we just fitted the data with Corricoto model to measure the metastability and the synchrony of the brain system. Basically, synchrony is say how much the nodes in the system get synced together versus they are segregated and act individually. And the metastability is measure how the variance of how much the nodes in the system goes from in phase to out of phase. Our results suggest that the nodes in the frontal parietal control network are flexible early during flow but decrease and stabilize over time, and nodes in subcortical structure have comparably low flexibility during flow across all windows and appear to stabilize in later windows. And the whole brain is more synchronized during flow than boredom, and subcortical structures have higher metastability during flow than boredom. So the conclusion is that we replicate the previous studies that the self-reported flow and the behavioral measure of attention is a inverse the U-shaped curve as a function of difficulty. And second, based on our fMRI data analysis, we find that there is likely to have so for frontal parietal, there is relatively high flexibility in early stage and then it goes stabilize. But for subcortical network, there is low flexibility across all the time, but it also seems to stabilize across time. And the synchrony measure is higher in flow than in the boredom, and the metastability is higher in flow than in boredom. So the conclusion here is that the flow may require a stabilization of brain network organization that emerges over time. Okay, thank you very much. Please feel free to check our website and download the resources. And here is the pictures of our coordinators. So if you have any questions, just ask in the session. Thank you.